and a place of green pasture and a place of refreshment. For her pain, sorrow, and sighing have fled away. As a good and loving God, forgive every sin she has committed, in word, deed, or thought. For there is no one who lives and does not sin. You are alone, are without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your word is truth. Saint Parthenios appeals, brief life of the saint, desiring to behold his dead fiancée with his own eyes. When he was a young man, he went to the tomb at night, uncovered her, and took her in his arms. He philosophized, as is said in the hymns from the funeral service, "We went out and stood in the tomb
decided to live in asceticism. There he lived with fasting, vigil, and prayer day and night. The Lord, beholding his spiritual feats, bestowed on him many spiritual gifts, among which was clairvoyance. He told the great and terrible earthquake of Chios. He foretold of the great and terrible earthquake of Chios in 1881. Soon his fame grew, and the abandoned church of St. Mark was transformed into a seat where St. Parthenios and his disciples performed their monastic duties. All the people gathered from the various parts of the island to hear his sweet word and to seek his prayer and blessing. Blasarius of Zanaras, the teacher, relates that without the will of the saint, St. Parthenios performed many miracles in his life. He recalls